Speaking of dates, you actually mentioned probably the first love of your life in the book, Rita.
She's here tonight.
I believe Rita's husband is sitting next to me. Tell us about Rita, Paul.
Which I guess has gotten a surprising amount of attention, but was unusual at the time. Rita cooked a very nice dinner of, I think it was baked chicken, and Bill attacked his chicken with a spoon. And after dinner, Rita came to me and said, "Can you believe he ate it with a spoon?" And I said, "I was surprised too." But it was great chicken. We do, yeah. We have a meal a couple times a year, and it's wonderful to stay in contact with your old friends and acquaintances.
Tell us about your yachts.
They're too big and there are too many of them. But do I need to say anything else? No. I mean, I think that I grew up seeing films like Silent World. It's a Jacques Cousteau movie about his diving, his wonderful diving saucer and all these adventures they had underwater. So, the biggest yacht that I have basically accommodates a submarine. And what these guys do, these captains, they'll say, "Paul, we know you want to build a bigger boat. And here's a model. It's about this big. And the submarine goes in the back here. And it's gonna be pretty good sized." And then they start building it. You go to Germany, you see it, you go, "Oh my gosh, that's really big." No, it's enormous. But we've been able to have adventures. We recently did a trip to Antarctica, which was fabulous, although it's disappointing to see. It turns out that the poles are disproportionately affected by global warming, so scientists are happy to show you, here's what the ice just in the bay that you're anchored in looked like 20 years ago, and here's how half of that ice is gone completely in 20 years. So for all those that say there is no effects of global warming, or it's just seasonal variation or whatever, you go to the poles and you can fly over Mount Kilimanjaro, whatever, it's happening. It's happening. But anyway, we've had wonderful adventures on the yachts, and I love to scuba dive. And you know, if you have the crazy success in some of these things that I've been fortunate to enjoy, you think about trying to realize some of those dreams, and I guess the yachts are one example of that. And then some of my friends, they just rent the yachts; they don't own them.
Yeah.
So, but if you own them, they're a lot of fun. I have great times in the yachts.
In the submarine?
Yeah. It's really, it turns out if you go 1,000 feet down the ocean, it's really dark. The animals are really strange, but if you put on some Pink Floyd, it's fantastic.